according to the United States Census Bureau, by the year 2042, Caucasian people in America will be the minority. By 2042, you're dealing with people whose bodies cannot sustain life. Right now, more white women's wombs are not able to hold a baby up to 9.5 months, and they're having miscarriages. So they're having more deaths than births, according to the United States Census Bureau. When you're dealing with a group of people who look at their livelihood and it is dwindling, there are actions that need to be taken. So not only do we have the black women being encouraged to have hysterectomies, but we have the white women being encouraged to have more children. You have the abortion clinics in 78% of the inner city neighborhoods, while you have the majority of fertility clinics in the rich neighborhoods. You have body parts. Women, black women, are being encouraged to get hysterectomies, but those hysterectomies are not being petitioned to be received by trans men. It gets very deep.
Wow.
Very deep. I know. Curveball. I know.
That took a turn.
I know. Another thing, you have organs, kidneys, you have lungs, hearts, etc., that are on the underground white market because black people don't control it. White and Jewish people primarily do control it, so I can't call it the black market. It's the white market. Okay, number one. Number two, hearts are worth a little over $100,000. Kidneys are worth over $20,000-$50,000, depending on where it is. And those black body parts, hence why 75,000 plus black men are missing. A lot of these children, 2,500 every year, are missing.
It sounds like Get Out.
It is Get Out. That movie was based on true stories happening all over the place. In America, right now, it is a $30 billion sex trafficking commercialized industry, meaning the money made from sex trafficking of children and women is now contributing to America's economic base. It is not a secret anymore.
And organ trafficking.
And organ trafficking, because people are dying. Which is why you shouldn't put organ donor on your driver's license. Because that makes you a target. This is a real world we're dealing with, y'all. Now, you brought me on Drink Champs, damn it. We dropping the real information.
You gotta drop the real.
A bunker in Phoenix, Arizona, a couple months ago with refrigerators full of hearts, kidneys, a few heads, body parts. In refrigerators. This is a very real thing.
Critical question is, can we protect melanin? And they're saying up in our faces, you can't do anything about what I decide to do to you. Now, if we don't look at that challenge, if we direct our attention to other things, a massive movement is going on. Melanin is being destroyed. And the slaughter will continue. So I say, and I know you've heard me say this before, that when I say that the system of racism, white supremacy, is the critical thing that we must focus on, because that is what is waging war against us. The white people came up with a plan some years back, Global 2000, in which they said it's too many people of color on this planet. By the year 2000, it's necessary to get rid of 2 billion. They are about business. They are about serious business, removing as they deem necessary the people of melanin on this planet. If we do not understand and make an analysis that this is fundamental, it is this dynamic that is taking us out. So I believe that it is time for us, if we don't see the war, we're in serious trouble. If we don't see the threat, we are in serious trouble. Down at the Black Caucus, they were giving all the statistics. 66% of black children being born in single-family households. That's not to demean that household. White supremacy is saying, I'm taking away the conditions for enhancing black masculinity. I'm taking away the conditions through which you might produce soldiers to carry on activity on your side of the chessboard. In addition, Since I have your situation so strung out and you watch more television than anybody else, I'm gonna serve up to you men dressed as women. And I'm gonna have you sit there in your frustration. Women and male children. And serve up laughingly in your face, black men dressed as women. Do you all understand me? This is a serious war.
Look into Washington. If we are not in unity, we can't force the Justice Department to do right by us. So we're going to have to unite and be willing to pay the price to be free. It's better to be dead than to live like we're living. You don't have any life. Look at your people. But it's because of us that don't love and respect our women enough that a white man could do that to a black woman and expect nothing in return. No people allow their women to be hurt and they don't come back with something? What kind of men have we become? And as long as your woman is a bitch and a whore in your mind, you'll never stand up for her. And if you won't stand up for her and the children that she produces for us, it is better that we be dead. And soon you will be. We got to stand up.
All you scared to death Negroes. Just sit down.